First, today at noon, the courtroom watched the video of Don Brancho just before being pulled under by a killer whale. Good afternoon, I'm Jason Guy.
And I'm Sion Rhodes. The final moments of Brancho's life were caught on home video and surveillance video at SeaWorld Orlando. The killer whale Tillicum grabbed her and pulled her underwater, drowning her February 1st of last year.
West 2's Dave McDaniel is live outside the Seminole County Courthouse. Dave, will the video of Brancho being pulled under be shown in court?
Well, that's something we don't know at this point. The Brancho family attorneys are in court, and they are here primarily to make sure that that video never gets shown to the public. They believe it violates her right to privacy. It's possible that video might get shown back in chambers, so only the judge and the attorneys would be witnessing that particular video. That remains to be seen. Basically, OSHA is made a finding that SeaWorld willfully violated safety regulations by letting trainers get far too close to these killer whales. SeaWorld disputes that, saying that its training is top-notch and that its trainers are as safe as they can be. But that video of Don Brancho just before she was killed dominated OSHA's case this morning. SeaWorld guests had their cameras rolling during the Dine with Shamu show back in February of 2010. In the moments before she was pulled into the pool and killed, Don Brancho was dancing with the whale, tossing water and fish at Tillicum. To guests, it appeared her comfort level around Tillicum was huge. At one point, Brancho was on a shallow ledge right in front of the whale. It was shortly after this footage, Brancho was grabbed. No other video has been shown in court yet. OSHA's attorney asked the security officer on duty when Brancho was killed whether he wrote in his report that she was pulled in by her arm. He said yes. SeaWorld's attorney pushed the point Brancho could have been pulled in by her ponytail. The officer said it was hard to tell and that he wasn't sure. OSHA contends having trainers overly close to whales creates gaps, which can allow serious injury or death. The co-founder of the Orca Project agrees.
Unlike what SeaWorld says, he didn't grab her ponytail. As you can see now with the evidence and the eyewitnesses that are coming forward, he already had her arm in his mouth. And he was moving, and he took her down from there.
The Orca Project, an organization formed after Brancho's death, says if she was pulled in by her arm, it proves problems in SeaWorld safety.
Just proves that these sentient, intelligent beings don't belong in tiny little pools when they swim over 100 miles a day with their family.
And again, the latest witness on the witness stand was a senior trainer from SeaWorld. She was testifying about the special rules that were in place for dealing with Tillicum. Primarily, she said, because of his size and because he was very possessive of the water. She said anything that went into the water, it was unlikely if Tillicum would give it back. Reporting live at the Seminole County Courthouse, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.